Good Friday, guys. How we doing? Got a Friday feeling? Welcome to the very first episode of my Mass Effect series. Hope you're feeling good. And yeah, I'm just getting this started for you guys today. This upload schedule is going to be every Friday, Saturday, Monday and Tuesday, and I may throw in a couple bonus episodes in between depending how we're doing. And yeah, I hope you enjoy. I've seen a lot of comments, you know, say male, biotic, and I've, you know, it was half and half on the Renegade Paragon option. And I think I'm just going to do a mix of both. I do hope you enjoy. Now, just so you guys know, I'm mainly focusing on the main game. I will do some of the side quests, if not all of them. You know, really I'm just doing the ones that I feel are going to be important for the entire game as a series. And I'm not looking to do every individual quest. I mean, if you want me to do that, maybe in the future, then I will do another playthrough. Internal emissions sync engaged. All systems online. Drift, just under 1500K. 1500 is good. Your captain will be pleased. I hate that guy. Minus gave you a compliment, so you hate him. I am looking at keeping these episodes around 40 minutes long. If you feel that's too long, let me know down in the comments. And you know, I will shorten it as the recording goes on. They have a right to send someone to keep an eye on their investment. Yeah, that is the official story. Only an idiot believes the official story.
They don't send specters on shakedown.
So there's more going on here than the captain's letting up.
Joker, status report.
Just cleared the mass relay, Captain. Stealth systems engaged. Everything looks solid.
Good. Find a comm buoy and link us into the network. I want mission reports relayed back to Alliance brass before we reach the prime.
Aye, aye, Captain. Better brace yourself, sir. I think Nihilus is headed your way.
He's already here, Lieutenant. Tell Commander Shepard to meet me in the comm room for a debriefing.
You get that, Commander?
He sounds angry. Something must have gone wrong with the mission.
Captain always sounds like that when he's talking to me.
Can't possibly imagine why.
Right, now we've got a control. Let's get on with this. Hi Nihilus, it's me again for my probably 18th playthrough.
What about?
I'm interested in this world we're going to, Eden Prime. I've heard it's quite beautiful.
They say it's a paradise.
Yes, a paradise. Serene, tranquil, safe. Eden Prime has become something of a symbol for you.
Just so you know, guys, I have gone a Vanguard, so primarily biotic, but with the ability to use pistols and shotguns.
Do you know something? Your people are still
being stuck with medium armor.
It can be a very dangerous place.
think it's about time we told the commander what's really going on.
This mission is far more than a simple shakedown run.
I already figured that out.
We're making a covert pickup with Eden Prime. That's why we needed the stealth system operation.
There must be a reason you didn't tell me about this, sir.
This comes down to the top, Commander. Information strictly on a need-to-know basis. A research team on Eden Prime unearthed some kind of beacon during an excavation.
I also hope you guys are enjoying mine on the King Woodsy 56's Arkham race.
Their legacy still remains. The mass relays, the Citadel, our ship.
Part 7 Hazard just came out today. So, you know, if you haven't seen it already, be sure to go back and watch it. I will leave it in the end cards to make it quicker for you.
Obviously, this goes beyond mere human interests, Commander. This discovery could affect every species in Council space.
It never hurts to have a few extra hands on board.
The beacon is not the only reason I'm here, Shepard.
Nihilus wants to see you in action, Commander. He's here to evaluate you.
What's going on, Captain?
The Alliance has been pushing for this for a long time. Humanity wants a larger role in shaping interstellar policy. We want more say with the Citadel Council. The Spectres represent the Council's power and authority. If they accept a human in their ranks, it shows how far the Alliance has come.
Not many could have survived what you went through on Akuz. You showed a remarkable will to live, a particularly useful talent. That's why I put your name forward as a candidate for the Spectres.
Why would a Turian want a human in the Spectres?
Not all Turians resent humanity. Some of us see the potential of your species. We see what you have to offer to the rest of the galaxy, and to the Spectres. We are an elite group. It's rare to find an individual with the skills we seek. I don't care that you're human, Shepard. I only care that you can do the job.
I assume this is good for the Alliance.
Earth needs this, Shepard. We're counting on you.
I need to see your skills for myself, Commander. Eden Prime will be the first of several.
I am hoping, you know, in the later videos, you know, a face cam will be available, but I can't guarantee that you ever see the whole face cam throughout this episode. I will try my best. But it is something I'm looking at doing.
Their citadel is the very heart of galactic society, and without their mass relays, interstellar travel would be impossible. We all owe the Protheans a great debt.
I'd like to know more about Eden Prime before we touch down.
It's a peaceful farming world, but it represents something much bigger. Eden Prime is one of our oldest and most successful colonies. It proved we were ready to face the challenges of settling new worlds, to forge a place for humanity beyond Earth. It symbolizes humanity's growth and evolution as a space-faring species. And after this, it will be known as the world where humans made a discovery of galactic importance.
Why is this beacon so important?
All advanced galactic civilization is based on Prothean technology, even yours.
If we hadn't discovered those Prothean ruins buried on Mars, we'd still be stuck on Earth. That was just a small data cache. Who knows what we can learn from this beacon? What if it's a weapons archive? We can't let it fall into the wrong hands.
Like who?
The Attican Traverse isn't the most stable sector of Citadel space. There are plenty of raiders and criminal groups active in the region. They might figure a Prothean beacon is worth the risk of attacking an Alliance ship. Plus, Eden Prime is right on the border of the Terminus systems.
The Attican Traverse is under Citadel protection.
Also, drop down in the comments, which is your favorite Mass Effect game? For me, Mass Effect 2 is my absolute favorite. I think the story was well written, and you know, the length was just perfect. So yeah, I want to know your favorites down in the comments.
We should be getting close to Eden.
Captain, we got a problem.
What's wrong, Joker?
Transmission from Eden.
Also, if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button, give us a like, maybe even share with your friends, because I will be doing more content like this as soon enough.
Get down.
ground traffic at all. It just goes dead. There's nothing.
Reverse mode of 38.1. Status report.
I'll just tell it when a Torian is nervous. Look at his face. Just watch those whiskers go.
This mission just got a lot more complicated.
A small strike team can move quickly without drawing attention. It's our best chance to secure the beacon.
Grab your gear and meet us in the cargo hold. Tell Alenko and Jenkins to suit up, Commander. You go again.
Engaging stealth systems. Somebody was doing some serious digging here, Captain.
Your team's the muzzle of this operation, Commander. Go in heavy and head straight for the dig site.
What about survivors, Captain?
Helping survivors is a secondary objective. The beacon's your top priority.
Approaching drop point one.
Nylund, you coming with us?
I move faster on my own.
Nylas will scout out ahead. He will feed you status reports throughout the mission. Otherwise, I want radio silence.
We've got his back, Captain.
The mission's yours now, Shepard. Good luck.
We are approaching drop point two.
For this game, I will be allowing the use of shotguns, pistols, and sniper rifles. Mainly because in Mass Effect 2, I can assign myself the ability to use sniper rifles. And that is something I will be doing for definite. So yeah, without further ado, let's equip my shotgun. And just move out. Shocker Storbers. Ooh, 3 points just for starting the game. Let's go throw and singularity. One in decryption and another throw. Jenkins says, I must say, guys. At this point, it does feel really strange starting from the very beginning. I usually do a new game plus, but I thought I'll make this run more challenging for myself to give you a much better content. Jenkins. I think for me, the shotgun is probably my most underrated weapon. I tend to go snipers and assaults. Also, guys, I will be allowing you to choose who I save and who I let die on the Fermi mission. So, yo, get your votes in now. You have up until the episode before the Fermi mission. And I will be tallying them just before I start recording that one. Conquerors, that's why. Duh. Come on, Caden, keep up.
Just over that rise. It might still be there.
We could use your help, Williams.
Aye, aye, sir. It's time for payback.
Move out.
I think weapon overloading is by far the worst thing they could ever added into this game. I much prefer the thermal clips you get from Mass Effect 2 and 3.
Thank you. It must have been moved.
Really? Captain Obvious?
Hard to say. Maybe we'll know more after we check out the research camp.
You think anyone got out of here alive?
If they were lucky. Maybe hiding up in the camp. It's just on the top of this ridge, up the ramps.
Change of plans, Shepard. There's a small spaceport up ahead. I want to check it out.
Wait for us, Nihilus. Sorry, I'm going quiet, guys. I'm keeping an eye on my recording system. It has a habit of not working. So I'm just making sure it's still recording. Yes, it is, Manuel. I love doing that.
What did you do?
I'm keeping him quiet.
You can't just go around whacking people in the head.
It was only a matter of time until he did something crazy and dangerous.
I suppose you're right. By the time he wakes up, the meds will have kicked in.
You're welcome.
Did you notice a Turian in the area?
No, I'm sorry. We haven't left the shed since the attack.
What else can you tell me about the attack?
So fast. One second we were gathering up our equipment, the next we were hiding in the shed while the Geth swarmed over the camp. We could hear the battle outside, gunfire, screams. I thought it would never end. Then everything went quiet. We just sat there, too afraid to move, until you came along.
You about the beacon?
It's some type of data module from a galaxy-wide communications network, remarkably well-preserved. It could be the greatest scientific discovery of our lifetime. Who knows what secrets are locked inside? Miraculous new technologies? Groundbreaking medical advances? The possibilities are endless.
Williams, take us to the spaceport.
Good luck, Commander.
Right, let's get to the spaceport, shall we? Oh, we would if there wasn't a cutscene.
This isn't your mission, Saren. What are you doing here?
The
council thought you could use some help on this one.
Yeah, in the future, guys, I may do the original Mass Effect trilogy instead of using the Mass Effect Legendary Edition. And with that one, I will do everything, including the Pinnacle Station. If that is something you want to see, let me know. Damn. Say good night, birdie. I will say, when it comes to the DLC, I will be doing all of that.
You're okay now. Nobody's gonna hurt you.
Those things were crawling all around the ship. They would have found us for sure. We owe you our lives.
I still can't believe it. When we saw that ship, I thought it was all over.
It showed up right before the attack. Knew it was trouble the second I saw it. So we made a break for the sheds.
I have to go.
Hey, Cole, we're just a bunch of farmers. These guys are soldiers. Maybe we should give them the stuff.
Jeez, Blake, you've got to learn when to shut up.
You have something to tell me, Cole?
Some guys at the spaceport were running a small smuggling ring. Nothing major. In exchange for a cut of the profits, we let them store packages in our shed.
You greedy bastard. You weren't running for your life. You were running to check on your merchandise.
No, it's not like that. I just knew there were some packages here. Something we could use. I found a pistol. I figured it would come in handy if those things came back. But you'll probably get more use out of it than we will.
We're risking our lives to save this colony. You sure there's nothing else in here that could help us out?
Yeah, there's one more thing. I was gonna sell it after this was over, but you probably deserve it more than I do.
Yes, I do. I'm out here saving your backside.
Who's your contact at the spaceport, Cole? What's his name?
He's not a bad guy. I don't want to get him in trouble. Besides, I'm not a snitch.
He might have something to do with this whole attack, Cole. We need his name. It's important.
Yeah, okay, you're right. His name's Powell. Works the docks at the spaceport if he's still alive.
I have to go.
Good luck.
Not sure if anyone actually knew about that. I didn't find that out until quite recently. Glitches.
Commander,
it's Lilas. Yeah, he's dead. He's not going anywhere.
A Turian? You know him?
Yup.
He was with us on the north.
Something's moving over behind those crates.
Don't shoot! I'm one of you! I'm human!
I like the way you hid behind those crates during the fight. It really helped us out. Thanks a lot.
Me? But I'm just a dock worker. I don't even have a weapon.
My name's Powell. I saw what happened to that Turian. The other one shot him.
What the hell are you talking about?
There were two Turians here, your friend and another one he called Saren. I think they knew each other. Your friend seemed to relax. He let his guard down. And Saren killed him. Shot him right in the back. I'm just lucky he didn't see me behind the crates.
We were told the Prothean beacon was brought to the spaceport. What happened to it?
It's over on the other platform, probably where that guy Saren was headed. He hopped on the cargo train right after he killed your friend. I knew that beacon was in trouble. Everything's gone to hell since we found it. First that damn mothership showed up, then the attack. They killed everyone. Everyone. If I had been behind the crates, I'd be dead too.
Your close contact here on the docks for the smuggling ring.
What? No! I mean, what does it matter now? So I'm a smuggler, who cares? My supervisor's dead, the entire crew's dead. Doesn't matter now, does it?
Anything hidden nearby that we could use against the Geth?
A shipment of grenades came through last week. Nobody notices if a few small pieces go missing for the military orders.
You greedy son of a bitch! We're out here trying to protect your sorry ass, and all you can think about is how you can rip us off?
I never thought you'd actually need those grenades. Who would want to attack Eden Prime? We're just a bunch of farmers. How was I supposed to know?
Hand over those grenades. Now.
They're yours. Take them. My smuggling days are over, I swear.
We need to find that beacon before it's too late.
Take the cargo train. That's where the other Turian went. I can't stay here. I need to get away from all this.
If you ask me, that is some nice shooting. I'm probably going to wrap it up after I finish it. Eden Prime.
Destroy the entire colony. Leave no evidence that we were here.
Really? I thought I'd just, wait for them to blow us all up.
Thank you.
Just grab all of these. And I will also be showing you a secret little cutscene as well. If I can find the correct spot. Here we go, a secret little cutscene. That looks bad. I don't think we can grow anything on that. Let's hit the speaker.
Normandy, the beacon is secure.
This is amazing. Actual working Prothean technology. Unbelievable.
It wasn't doing anything like that when they dug it up. Something must have activated it.
Roger, Normandy. Standing by.
Oh, Ashley, you idiot. Is it me or does that look like it hurts? Can't be just me, can it?
We identified the ship that touched down on Eden Prime, the Normandy, a human alliance vessel. It was under the command of Captain Anderson. They managed to save the colony.
And the beacon.
One of the humans may have used it.
Uh-oh, someone upset the toddler. But to be fair, I think he is one of the best well-written villains in this series. Alright guys, after this bit, I am going to be signing off.
You have us worried there, Shepard. How are you feeling?
Like the morning after shore leave. How long was I out?
About 15 hours. Something
sounds like a good sleep.
It's my fault. I must have triggered some kind of security field when I approached it. You had to push me out of the way.
You had no way to know what would happen.
Actually, we don't even know if that's what set it off. Unfortunately, we'll never get the chance to find out.
The beacon exploded. A system overload, maybe. The blast knocked you cold. The lieutenant and I carried you back here to the ship.
What's the damage, Doctor?
Physically, you're fine. But I detected some unusual brain activity. Abnormal beta waves. I also noticed an increase in your rapid eye movement. Signs typically associated with intense dreaming.
I saw. I'm not sure what I saw. Death.
Just so you know, when it comes to that option, it doesn't matter what you pick. He always says the same thing. Because every plot revolves around something like a beacon.
Tell us what Saren was after?
Just before I lost consciousness, I had some kind of vision.
A vision? A vision of what?
I saw synthetics. Geth, maybe. Slaughtering people. Butchering them.
We need to report this to the council, Shepard.
I think I'm crazy.
We don't know what information was stored in that beacon. Lost Prothean technology, blueprints for some ancient weapon of mass destruction, whatever it was. Saren took it. But I know Saren. I know his reputation is politics. He believes humans are a blight on the galaxy. This attack was an act of war. He has the secrets from the beacon. He has an army of Geth at his command, and he won't stop until he's wiped humanity from the face of the galaxy.
I'll find some way to take him down.
It's not that.
Oh, there's always so much talking in these things, isn't there?
That's why we need the council on our side.
We prove Saren's gone rogue, and the council will revoke his Spectre status.
I'll contact the ambassador and see if he can get us an audience with the council. He'll want to see us as soon as we reach the Citadel. We should be getting close. Head up to the bridge and tell Joker to bring us into dock.
Alright, guys. I am going to sign off here. So, have a good weekend. I shall see you here, same time tomorrow. So, have a good Friday. Remember, keep that Friday feeling going. This is Commander Cessus signing off. Goodbye.